Kendrick Lamar failed hip-hop. You probably know by now that Kendrick Lamar dissed his rap peers Drake and J. Cole. Unlike that, a diss that got everyone talking about who was better than who and why they're better. Kendrick Lamar made Good Kid, Mad City, Drake made Take Care, J. Cole made Forest Hills Drive. It's all semantics in this rap game. You're going to like who speaks to you and your taste the most. No one can tell you anything wrong about this rapper music-wise. No one's going to switch sides or jump ship from a fan base over a diss song. Then the grand scheme of things means absolutely nothing.
Let me cook.
When I hear Kendrick Lamar's verse, it's very obvious he has some type of vitriol hate towards Drake in particular. Which is fair, they have traded subliminals since 2013 when KDOT last challenged the rap game on Control, but the difference between Control and now is the purpose. The Control verse was about keeping the emerging rappers hungry. People like Drake, Tyler, Cole, and Big Sean, yeah, we talking Big Sean, went on to drop some of their most well-reviewed and popular albums after that. So this diss came from a good place, a place of competition. Because what's fun about dominating a game full of D2 players when you belong in the NBA? But a diss from Kendrick Lamar in Big 2024 just sounds out of place. Following an album about detaching himself from ego and pride that wouldn't allow him to forgive people like Jimmy, I mean Drake. If anything, the perfect time to drop a scathing diss track was 7 years ago, around the time he was dropping Damn. I mean, it already was supposed to have a Big Sean diss that leaked a couple months ago. Side note, why does he keep talking about Big Sean? What did this dude do to you, bruh? He's not that important. Anyway, Drake at this time was just entering an era of unprecedented laziness. We all get that steel sharpened steel, and it should be the same way with competition. If Kendrick Lamar had spoken up in 2017, we could have extended this era of music for a long time. Instead of experiencing that though, we followed a bored Drake as he started to experiment with all types of music. He even made a whole album of house music, making music with Sexy Red, and in music videos like this. When the rap game needed Kendrick Lamar the most, he vanished, and we decided to emerge again. He decided to hop on a track on what looked like to be a man hurt by Drake taking a stripper from him, and a man that sneak disses on Twitter and then gets mad when folks respond. The optics, man, they just don't look great. This is not good for the competition because these guys are not going to get any bigger than they are now. They are the big three. There is no question about it. Is one better than the other? Sure, I guess, but the only person who really cares about that are the booty scratching, nose picking, mouth breathing waste of spaces on Twitter. Drake is better because he releases more albums every year. Cole's better because he went platinum with no features. No, Kendrick Lamar's better because his wordplay is just unbelievable, man. Most people are arguing about these artists don't even listen to all of them because they don't fit their lifestyle. Of course, you're going to listen to more Drake if you go to more parties, or you listen to more Kendrick Lamar if you like introspective and reflective music. This will be a never-ending cycle of people debating their faves, because no one will ever dethrone their faves. This will add nothing to the overall state of music. I mean, we literally just saw it with Jermaine. You made him do a 7-minute warm-up talking gibberish about Kendrick Lamar's albums. What did you want him to say? These aren't the scathing 2018, 2015, or 1996 rap disses. These guys were friends. Well, at least one of them are friends with both of them. I don't see any disses that are amazing or worthwhile. And I don't think we're gonna get a response from Drake, because I'm guessing every time he tries to go to the studio, he thinks about the times he had with Future and their friendship, and he just goes and cries in the shower for an hour or two. These guys are almost 40 with wives and kids trying to beef like they're 25 again. Nah, you just gotta leave that in the past. I know Kendrick could be doing this for another revitalization of some sort, but from him, of all people, going the negative route just seems backwards. It just doesn't fit the continuity for me. So yeah, that's why I think Kendrick Lamar failed hip-hop. He should have dropped this years ago if that's how he really felt. You can tell everyone how you feel about this geriatric rap beef down below in the comment section or on Twitter, as most of you have already done. Leave a like and sub if you enjoyed, and Jimmy, I'm just playing. You know I love you.